There goes my heart beating, 'cause you are the reason I'm losing my sleep. Please come back now. There goes my mind racing, and you are the reason that I'm still breathing. I'm hopeless now. I'd climb every mountain and swim every ocean just to be with you and fix what I broke. Oh, 'cause I need you to see that you are the reason. There goes my head shaking, and you are the reason my heart keeps beating, and I need you now. And if I could turn back the clock, I'd make sure the light defeated the dark. I'd spend every hour of every day I'd climb every mountain and swim every ocean just to be with you and fix what I broke. Oh, 'cause I need you to see that you are the reason. I'd climb every mountain and swim every ocean just to be with you and fix what I've broken. Oh, 'cause I need you to you are the
coming out and braving the craziness of this world to be with us today for Amanda and Brandon. I would ask that you please put your phones away, put them off, put them on vibrate. But Amanda and Brandon have quite an army of photographers and videographers, and they want to make this moment here special. As soon as the ceremony is over, you're more than welcome to pull your phones out and take your own pictures and whatnot. But if you can please put them away or put them on silent or vibrate at this moment. Thank you. I have a few things I wrote down. It's just the way it is. It's 2020, right? I want to ask everybody to bow their heads and open prayer, please.
Dear Heavenly Father, thank you for the gift of marriage, for all the joy and love that it brings us. We thank you for Amanda and Brandon. We thank you that you have brought them together for this special day, and that you hold them safely in your hands. We pray that you would richly bless them as they exchange their vows and their wedding rings. That from this day forward, they would walk hand in hand into everything that you have destined them to be. We give our hearts and our beings to you now in adoration. We welcome your Holy Spirit amongst us. Amen.
Amen.
I got away with it easy here. Amanda and Brandon asked me to officiate their wedding. That's the one condition. You guys are eternal vows. We'll get to that shortly. I also wrote down just something that I thought was really cool. We've had the pleasure of having Brandon with us at the house for the last, it seems like he's turned Brandon. Probably the last 3 years, I guess, 4 years, maybe 3 years. And by the way, regardless of what Amanda thought, we could use them. We just accepted it as one of our own. And I don't know if they let you know or not, but they're going to hyphenate the last name. Just kidding. Brandon was adamant about that. It was going to be running joke. But, you know, we've accepted you, everything you do. You're good. You're perfect for our God. You balance your good luck. But you balance your really good and easy. And we're excited to be official and have you part of our family. So a few things on love, and you guys have seen this reception, but there's a lot of history out here. You guys can ask anybody, and Amanda, hopefully with your own parents, your mother and I, you've taken over the years what you need and what you can use and left the rest, because life gets rough. I mean, it does. But here we are, 21 plus years later, living the dream. So, you know, I just ask that you guys truly enjoy each other over the years. Brandon, slow down a little, please. You know, man, nothing else to do. You know, you guys have already made your destiny to move to Texas and start here. Overall, we're excited for you, and you know, we're just as anxious as you guys. It's a big step. We have faith that you guys are going to, well, we talk about it on the drive out there, that, you know, some things that you just have to do no matter where you go. You know, we talked about the church, and I know Amanda, your mother's talked to you about the church. It's important. We live in a crazy, crazy world, and it's important to find that structure, that foundation. I just ask you guys to fall in love, be passionate, fearless. Listen to your heart, be thoughtful and generous, believe in love at first sight. Hold hands, laugh nervously, write love letters, make handmade gifts. Get dressed up for a date, feel butterflies in your stomach. Run away together, stay in bed all day. Create memories that will tell your grandchildren about. Cuddle, learn from each other, be patient and kind with your words. Grow old together, be spontaneous and impulsive. Kiss each other goodnight. Remember why you fell in love. And this will be your happily ever after. Now, you guys have vows you want to recite to each other.
I go first. That's not even that loud.
Yes.
Okay.
Your mic.
No. I can't promise you the dark clouds will never hover over our lives, or that the future will bring us many more, many rainbows. I can't promise you that tomorrow will be perfect, or that life will be easy. You my everlasting devotion, my loyalty, my respect, and my unconditional love for a lifetime. Oh. I can't promise that I'll always be here for you, to listen and to hold your hand, and to always do my best to make you happy and make you feel loved. I can promise that I'll see you through any crisis and pray with you, dream with you, build with you, and always cheer you on and encourage you. I can promise that I'll willingly be your protector, your advisor, your counselor, your friend, your family, your everything. I promise you.
You have made me the happiest man in the world today by wanting to share your life with me. I promise to always love and respect you. I promise to care for you and protect you. I promise to comfort you and encourage you. I promise to be with you through thick and thin. I promise you I will always be there whenever you need me. I promise to be with you for all of eternity. I love you, Amanda J. Nicole.
That's not my name yet.
Well, it's about to be.
So, thank you guys. Brendan, I'm going to ask you to repeat after me first, and then we'll go through it, and I'll ask you to repeat after me also.
I can't remember things.
I am honored to call you my wife.
I am honored to call you my wife.
With this ring.
With this ring.
I be wed.
Sorry.
I be wed.
I be wed.
And with it.
And with it.
I bestow.
I bestow.
Upon thee all the treasures.
Upon thee all the treasures.
Of my mind, heart, and hands.
Of my mind, heart, and hands.
Amanda.
Amanda.
I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my love.
As a symbol of my love.
As it encircles your finger.
As it encircles your finger.
May
Sorry.
It remind you always that you are surrounded.
May it remind you.
Always that you are surrounded.
Always that you are surrounded.
With my enduring love.
With my enduring love.
He put it on already.
Yes, you're fine. You're fine. You held it together.
Amanda. Yeah, stuff a little pat in the back.
I am honored to call you my husband.
I'm honored to call you my husband.
With this ring.
With this ring.
I be wed.
And with it.
And with it,
I bestow upon thee.
All the treasures of my mind.
Say it again.
All the treasures.
Of my mind.
Heart and hands.
Brandon.
I give you this ring. As a symbol of my love. As it encircles your finger. May it remind you always. That you are surrounded by my enduring love.
That's what's in the theater.
You good? It's
together.
Okay.
Ladies and gentlemen, by the power of the state of California.
The red.
I now pronounce you a husband and a wife. The meat is right.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. and Mrs. Brandon Ian Nicolau.
God, I can hold this together.
I'm wondering if your love's still strong.